Good morning to one and all. Today we will have a revision class of human digestion. Human digestion. So digestion means it is a process by which the complex food materials are converted into simple absorbable materials. What is the digestion? Digestion is a phenomenon or process by which a complex food material is converted into simple absorbable component for generating energy. So, digestion. When you talk about the digestion, digestion is a process of conversion means when you see the pulses plus rice, these are complex form. Try to assume that these are the complex form. This complex form is converted in the mixing into simpler form, that is paste for making idli. So here it is the complex, it is the intermediate, and it is the final. So conversion or process of conversion of complex food into simple absorbable and assimilated, converting into the energy form is called digestion. Okay, in this revision part, we will try to understand the digestion, the components. So, in order to understand the digestion, it is already that digestion from the animal kingdom is a organ system level of organization. So, it is a organ system level of organization. Why it is called organ system level of organization? So you can write the definition for digestion is this, or the conversion of complex food into simple absorbable food materials is called digestion. Now, when you try to understand this, so the process of conversion of complex food materials into simple, absorbable, assimilated food materials is called digestion. If you want to understand the digestion is of three types. Digestion can be divided into three parts. digestion can be divided into three parts. What are those? So already you know that it is a tissue level of organization. It is a tissue level of organization. So the digestion should be understood. Means you need to understand these three: anatomy, physiology, disorders of anatomical arrangement and physiology. So human digestion can be understood in these ways. The first one will try to understand the anatomy of human digestion. Means we'll only discuss the what are the parts involved, what are the organs involved, what are the glands involved, and how they are able to produce. So now we are trying to understand the anatomy of human digestion. Anatomy of human digestion. In this anatomy, so generally anatomy means, ana means cutting, tummy means seeing internal parts, cutting and seeing internal parts. Cutting and seeing the internal parts is called as anatomy. In the human digestive anatomy, so we will talk about the physiology and the disorders of anatomical arrangement of physiology later on. But today we will try to understand the anatomy. In the anatomy, we will start with the mouth. Mouth is one of the important parts. The second part in concern to the mouth, after the mouth, is called buccal cavity or oral cavity. The third one, pharynx. Fourth one, esophagus. Fifth one, stomach. Sixth part, small intestine. Large intestine, rectum, anus. So, in order to understand the human digestion, first we need to go with the anatomical parts of the human digestive system. In this, one by one we need to discuss. So here these are the parts in the order, and actually the elementary canal, we have used the term elementary canal. Generally elementary canal starts from esophagus and till rectum. Whatever the parts are included in this, like stomach, small intestine, large intestine, up to rectum, which is a tubular structure which is a So, the part from the esophagus to rectum, whatever are included, that is called as alimentary canal. So, this is completely called from here to rectum, whatever the parts are present, they are called as alimentary canal. And so alimentary canal does not completely form the digestive system. System is a group of organs which perform for the same function, means digestion process is called as digestive system. So the alimentary canal plus the associated or digestive glands plus these digestive gland ducts are tubes pouring the secretions directly into the digestive canal or alimentary canal. This collectively called as digestive system, collectively called as digestive system. In order to understand the digestive system, understand that we are bilaterally symmetrical means when the skeleton is cut into this position, at this portion, so this part when it is cut here, and when this part is remained same as this, including each and every organ, that is called as bilaterally symmetrical. So we are trying to understand our human digestive tract. The human digestive tract is present like this. This is the skeletal diagram and skeletal remnant of the human digestive system. So this part is called upper jaw. This part is called lower jaw. Only movable part in the human body digestive system is only the lower jaw. And here completely this is skull. So here these are two eye sockets. This is called nasal cavity. This is called as nasal cavity. Just below the nasal cavity, an opening is present called as mouth. So, in this skeleton, we can only see the teeth, but when this part, whatever the part you are seeing, this is called the mouth. Mouth opens into oral cavity, that part. So, the second one, buccal cavity or oral cavity. Buccal, why it is called buccal cavity means, as the upper layer is lined by a special type of tissue called as this one. This upper part, palate region is lined by buccal mucosa, so it is called as buccal cavity. And the lower portion, it is, you can see that the tongue is present, the tongue is attached to the lower jaw through the help of smooth tissue called as frenula. That one has frenula. And you can see that the teeth, there are 32 teeth in me. So here also you can see. So these 32 teeth are divided into two parts. That is, when you are cutting the human being into two equal parts, either this side portion is intact or this side portion is intact. When you take any one side of the two portions, either this side or this side, the number of teeth present on the top side, the number of teeth present on the lower side of one side, either this side or either this side, the number of teeth present from here to here, here to here on this side, or the number of teeth present from here to here, here to here on the lower jaw is said to be the dental formula. This side, the number of teeth up and down, or this side, the number of teeth up and down is called its dental formula. And from this, it moves into this portion, where this portion, in this portion, this will be connecting the oral cavity. The tongue is also present, but just below that a cavity is present called as pharynx. Pharynx is connected to the nasal cavity, to the nasal canals, and to the mouth through buccal cavity or oral cavity. So your pharynx is the connecting junction. Pharynx is the connecting junction between the respiratory system and digestive system. So from pharynx, whatever goes into the esophagus is called, esophagus is also called as food pipe, and esophagus will be on the back side and the trachea will be present on the front side. So your pharynx is the junction for, pharynx is the junction for digestive system and respiratory system. And from there on, it's a tube-like structure from the esophagus, almost from here to back side. This is the, here anus will be present. Here anus will be present till whatever the composition is present. Whatever the tube from here to here, and the stomach will be present on the left side, this side of the skeleton, and this side the liver is present. Here intestine is present, the large intestine middle, and the small intestine in the middle, the large intestine outer, covering all the visceral organs. So here the anus. So the tube present from the esophagus to the stomach, stomach to the small intestine to the large intestine. When you check the diagram, you will get an idea. So esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and rectum. These are collectively called, this is called as elementary canal. So to this elementary canal we have associated glands. The associated glands are three types. One is called as parotid gland. Parotid gland is present in this location. Parotid gland is present in this location. And the second submaxillary. The submaxillary glands are present in this location. And sublingual. Just below the tongue region. So sublingual glands are present. These are three pairs of salivary glands are present. These three pairs of salivary glands will pour the secretion into the oral cavity for lubrication of food as well as mastication of food and also for the digestion of food to make the process of digestion, initiation of digestion. So, once the food moves from the oral cavity with the help of tongue, teeth and enter into the esophagus, it will be moved into the stomach. And from the stomach it moves into the small intestine and from small intestine it moves into the large intestine and from the large intestine it will be stored in the descending part of the colon and rectum and when the defecation reflex occurs it will be passed out. And the next one, so it is passed out through the anus. So your elementary canal stands for the elementary canal stands from the esophagus to the rectum, including the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine up to the rectum, consequently called as, collectively called as the elementary canal. And we have discussed the three pairs of salivary glands are present in the mouth region. They are called as parotid gland, submaxillary gland and sublingual gland. Apart from that, on the right side you can see a gland called as liver. A liver is also present in this location with two lobes. And to this, a gallbladder is also present and they pour their secretions into the duodenum through the help of ampoule of water. And in this portion, a gland called pancreas is present. This pancreas also produces pancreatic juice. And liver produces bile juice. And salivary glands produces saliva. Salivary gland produces saliva. So these are the digestive glands and they produce their secretions. So because of this which digestion is possible. So as a result of this digestion process, you can see that the food, complex food is converted into simpler food. And absorbable and assimilated food. So we'll come one by one related to this topic. So, your mouth is located just below nasal cavity and lower jaw. So mouth is an opening, it is open, and the upper one is called upper lip, the lower one is called lower lip. Lower lip. The mouth leads into oral cavity. Mouth leads into oral cavity. So between the mouth to oral cavity opening, we see a empty space between the teeth. Teeth are located in this direction. In the tooth, one is the upper jaw and lower jaw. So the teeth, now the place present between the opening and the teeth is called vestibule. Now teeth, already we know that teeth are located like this. Okay, when you take the skull, when you take the skull and divide the skull into two equal halves, the number of teeth present on the upper jaw and lower jaw. So this is upper jaw, this is called lower jaw. Upper jaw and lower jaw. The teeth present on any one side, either this side you take or this side, any one side of bilateral, any one side of bilateral symmetry, they are called as dental formula. So any one side you take, that is called as the dental formula. And dental formula of adult, so either this side you take or this side you take, that is okay, 2, 1, 2, 3. And I am giving that arrow mark or dot mark. This indicates that separation. So again 2, 1, 2, 3. So you are writing only number 2, 1, 2, 3. I know what is that. Why are you writing? You can write as 3, 2, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 by 8, 16, 8 plus 8, 16. So here, this indicates the number of teeth of different type. So these two are indicating incisors. One is called canines. Two are called premolars, molars. So you have four different names given for four different type of teeth. For that reason we have written in 1, 2, 3. That is upper eight, lower eight. This is only one side of bilateral symmetry. This is only one side of the bilateral symmetry. So it is called as dental formula. So if you want to calculate the number of teeth, 8 by 9, other side, into 2. 2 is indicating that this 2 is, this is only one side, and the second side multiplied by 2 is equal to 16 by 16, that is equal to 32. So adult will be having 32 teeth. Adult will be having 32 teeth. So this is the very important question generally asked. 32 is the dental formula of a adult human being. So in the children, child, it is 2021. So this is the dental formula of child or milk teeth. That is 20 teeth. 2 to 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 into 2, 20 teeth are present in the adults, in the child.